So here, this is the styloid process, and this styloid process in most of the skulls, they might be broken. For example, here a part of it is there, here it is an entire styloid process over here. It is present over here, it is broken over here. This styloid process is present just deep to the external acoustic meatus, and just behind the styloid process, how beautifully you are able to appreciate this foramen, stylomastoid foramen. The structure which passes out of stylomastoid foramen, day before yesterday in the morning, I had taken that lecture about facial nerve. It will pass outside. Facial nerve passes outside through this foramen, stylomastoid foramen. And another structure will pass inside, and that will be known as the posterior tympanic branch of posterior auricular artery. So this is styloid process here. This styloid process will have attachment of various structures. Those structures will be taken in detail when we study the norma basalis. So there are several muscles and ligaments which are attached to the styloid process. Then we pass across to this zygomatic arch. Once again, the lower border of zygomatic arch will have the attachment of masseter muscle. Here there will be origin of masseter, and that masseter will be inserted lower down into the ramus of mandible. Masseter is a muscle of mastication. Then here we are able to appreciate maxillary tuberosity, and here we are able to appreciate pterygomaxillary fissure, as we have already discussed. This is the infratemporal crest of greater wing of sphenoid, infratemporal surface of greater wing of sphenoid, and this is the lateral pterygoid plate. Remember, my dear students, this is just norma lateralis. Norma lateralis, what we are able to view from lateral side, only that much we have to discuss. So this is the lateral pterygoid plate, lateral surface of lateral pterygoid plate. It is a part of sphenoid bone, and on this lateral surface of lateral pterygoid plate, there also will be attachment of the lateral pterygoid muscle. Similarly, lateral pterygoid muscle will take origin from infratemporal crest and infratemporal surface of greater wing of sphenoid also. These are masticatory muscles. It is not included in this, but the muscles of mastication such as lateral pterygoid, medial pterygoid, the temporalis and masseter will be discussed in detail during norma basalis. So, my dear students, this much is about norma lateralis.